Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Hope you all are doing good. In this video of honeymoon in Switzerland, I'm going to take you to Mount Titlis and take you around the old town of Luzern. If you have not checked out the part 1 of this video where I have taken you to Jungfrau, I'll link it in the description box so that you can check out that video. Day 3 in our trip to Switzerland had started very early. And we were all set to travel to Mount Titlis. Mount Titlis is located at 3,238 meters above the sea level and offers a stunning and panoramic view. During the winter season, the Titlis Glacier is an inviting destination for skiers. We started our journey from our hotel and we were taken first to Luzern. From there, we traveled to a place called Angelberg. From Angelberg, we took a cable car to reach a middle station at Standup. From that station, we had to take Titlis Rotair to reach the top of Mount Titlis. Okay, so here we are. We have boarded our first cable car from Angelberg. And we are going to a middle station using this cable car from where we'll take Titlis Rotair. We are just moving out of the station and look at the view below. It's wonderful, mesmerizing. This cable car takes you sharply up the hill and you can see the panoramic view before reaching Mount Titlis. The ride was a bit scary but mesmerizing with the view all around you. You can see in the video how sharply we are moving up the hill. The thick pine forest and the white snow within the forest made it look out of a fairy tale. As we gradually moved up the hill, we could see the small town of Angelberg right below there. And you can see how sharply we had taken up the hill in the cable car. These are small cable cars and has a seating capacity of maximum 4 people. It is advised not to stand up or move while the cable car is in motion. This will lead to the swinging of the car and it will make the ride dangerous and scary. The cable car takes you through thick pine forest and you can see the pine trees just below you. The view is awesome and mesmerizing. The journey in this cable car was a long one and we were taken to a middle station from where we would board the world's first 360-degree Rotair. Mount Titlis Rotair is the first rotating cable car. So while you are moving up in the cable car, it also rotates 360-degree, giving you a panoramic view of the steep rock faces, deep crevices and the snow-clad Mount Titlis. Riding the Titlis Rotair was a lifetime opportunity, but yet I would say this cable car was much scary than the Titlis Rotair. That is because the Titlis Rotair is a larger one and has a capacity of around 15 to 20 people. You can see the passing cable cars down the hill and you will get an idea how small these cable cars are. We have reached the middle station and the town of Angelberg looks like this from the station. I am about to step into the world's first 360-degree Rotair, taking me up to Mount Titlis. So let's go. I am inside world's first 360-degree Rotair and I'm really excited for the journey. These are big cable cars and has a capacity of around 15 to 20 people. The turnstile automatically closes after the capacity is full. I was one of the last person to step inside the Rotair, leaving my husband behind at the station because the turnstile had closed. And here everything is so strict that you cannot go out or my husband could not come in with me. I was not even allowed to swap places with another person because my ticket was already punched and the ticket cannot be transferred to another person. As soon as you step inside the Rotair, take a position near the glass windows and be assured that standing at that same place you can see 360-degree view of Mount Titlis. You don't need to worry that the view at the other side is better than your side because this rotator will rotate 360 degrees and you will get the view all around you. The journey takes about 5 minutes and in those 5 minutes you will get a panoramic view of Mount Titlis all around you. You can see steep rock faces, deep crevices and the snow-clad Alps. The beauty was mesmerizing and I was completely enchanted by the 360 degree view that the rotator gave. Right there you can see another rotator coming down the hill. As you can see, I am standing at the same place yet getting a 360 degree view of Mount Titlis. This is the speciality of this rotator or cable car. You can see some cable cars right down there. These are open cable cars for the Bravehearts. In these cable cars, you just sit and there's a seat belt and your feet is dangling in the air. Mount Titlis is a paradise for ski lovers. Many tourists from all over the world came with the skiing equipments to ski at the Mount Titlis Valley. If you are passionate about skiing or ice skating, you can carry your own equipments or you can hire equipments at Mount Titlis. I am almost at the top of Mount Titlis and about to reach the station. I am just taking the last few glimpses of Mount Titlis from this rotator before stepping out. I've reached at the top of Mount Titlis and met my husband who came in the next rotator. And now look at the view below. It's beautiful, mesmerizing and out of the world. It was difficult to say whether the mountain rose up to the sky or the sky came down to the Mount Titlis. It was very cold and windy. This is a platform from where you get a 360 degree view of Mount Titlis. You also have a telescope to see far away. Mount Titlis is also the most visited and must visit places in Switzerland like Jungfrau. I'll give you a 360 degree tour of the platform where we are standing before jumping into the snow. This place is so popular for skating and skiing that there are racks and stands for the ski equipments. So here you can see these are the stands for the ski equipments. Just as we take the right turn, we land straight into the snow. This is where the skiers go skiing. Even if you're not going for a ski, you definitely would want to go to the snow and enjoy it. As we were enjoying to our fullest, there was an alert of a storm approaching. The weather here changes abruptly and soon it started raining and snowing. The Titlis rotator had stopped its operation due to safety reasons and we were asked to descend immediately. Since the rotator had suspended its operation, we were taken down to the middle station through service ropeways. From there, we again took the small cable car down to the town of Luzon. As we travelled downhill, the weather worsened and the journey was very scary. It was very windy and the entire cable car was swinging. We came down to Luzon and spent the entire evening strolling around. Luzon is a town in Switzerland with a very old European charm. You can explore the Swiss chocolate shops and buy some for yourselves. You can explore the lakes or take a tram ride around the city. We visited the Chapel Bridge, which is a wooden footbridge spanning the river Reuss diagonally in the city. The medieval architecture and feel of the town will surely mesmerize you. Next, we visited the Lion Monument or the Lion of Luzon. This stone monument was made to honor the sacrifices of the Swiss Guards who were massacred during the French Revolution in 1792. We bought some chocolates for ourselves and our loved ones and enjoyed the sunset at Luzon. This was our last day in Switzerland and our Europe trip was about to end the next day. The next morning we had our return flight from Zurich to Kolkata via Hamad International Airport at Qatar. The 3 days at Switzerland was literally living a dream and one of the best days of my life. I hope you have enjoyed my Europe in Budget series with Paris, Belgium, Germany and Switzerland. If you haven't checked out the other videos in this series, do go and check it out and I'll leave the links in the description box. I hope you liked this video. If you have, do click the like button and do subscribe to my channel. For any queries regarding Europe trip in budget, do leave a comment in the comment section and I'll make sure to give you all the information. With awesome memories of Switzerland, I take farewell until we meet again. Do take care and bye-bye.